Good morning, students. Welcome to GC Tech Hub CS tutorials. In today's class, we are going to discuss conversion from decimal to decimal to octal and octal to decimal. As we all know that decimal numbers, they have base 10 and octal numbers are base 8 numbers. That is, every number is made up of 8, any combination of 8 digits, that is 0 to 7. So in order to convert any decimal number to octal number, we need to divide the number by 8 and collect the remainders upon dividing the number. So we are going to start with some examples with which you will understand the conversion. So the very first question which we have here, convert the following decimal numbers to octal. So as you can see here, there are some decimal numbers which we need to convert into octal number. So usually in your exam, you will get a question like this. That is, a decimal number would be given to you and this small subscripted number represents the base of the number. So it is the 10, the subscript 10 shows that this 19 number is a decimal number, and here 8 subscript shows that you have to convert 19 to octal number. So let us do this conversion. We start by dividing 19 by 8. We get the remainder 3, and we get now 2 as the quotient, and we know that we cannot divide it further. So we will be collecting the remainders from bottom to top. So 19 is represented using this form, that is, it is 23 to the base 8. So this is the octal representation of 19. So this was the first one. Let's see the second one now. So now we have 122 as the number. So we will again write it and we will divide it by 8. So as you can see that the quotient is 15 and the remainder is 2. So we will write the remainder over here. Now again we divide and we get 7 over here, and now it cannot be further divided. So the answer is 172 to the base 8. Next question is 161.25. So here you can see, just like when we had done binary decimal to binary, the number has a decimal part, that is a fractional part. So here 161, this is the integral part. And 25 is the fractional part. So we will be solving the integral and fractional part separately. First, we start with the integral part conversion. And it goes like this. We have to first convert 161 to octal form. And we will be using the repeated division method for that. So we get some answer, that is 241, which is the octal part of the integral part 161. Now we take up the fractional part. and the fractional part is 0.25. As you can see, because originally your number is 161.25, and so you can see over here that 161 was already taken. We have already done the conversion for integral part, and now we need to do the conversion for the fractional part, that is 0.25. Now, to convert fractional part into octal form, we had used the repeated multiplication, if you remember. For the integral part, we use repeated division method. And for the fractional part, we use the repeated multiplication method. So here we have 0.25, which we will be repeatedly multiplying with 8. So we get 2.00, out of which we will only take up the integral part and write it separately. Now we will just take this fractional part, and in the fractional part you can see that there are zeros after this, right? So that is the reason why we are not going to use this zero. I mean, we are not going to take up or continue this multiplication further, because we have got zeros in the fractional part and this is where we have to stop. So our fractional part 0.25 is 0.2 in octal form. Now we will combine both the parts, that is the integral part which was converted and the fractional part, and it becomes 241.2, which is my answer. Let us understand this by one more example. So let us just, instead of only taking 0.625, let me take a number here, that is 84, sorry, not 84 is not an octal number, 75.625, which is, sorry, we can take 85, yes, because we are converting decimal to octal, very sorry on that. So I'm writing 85. I'll take 185, and this is the decimal number which we are going to convert to octal. Here again, first of all, we take the integral part, and the integral part is 185. So we divide 185 by 8. We get the remainder as 1 and we get the quotient as 23. So we write 23 over here and the remainder over here. Now next is 23. So we divide it by 2. And we get the answer as 7 over here. So our integral part has been converted, that is 271. Now we have the fractional part. That is 0.625, which has to be converted to octal. So we will use the repeated multiplication here for the fractional part. And you can again see that we are getting 5.000, which gives us the integral part 5, and because we are getting all zeros after the decimal point, so we will stop. And now we combine both the parts. So this is the number. Let us take any other example, a random example where we will get to perform multiplication more than once. Suppose we have this number and we have to convert this to octal. So 185 can be converted simply by repeated division method. So again we get the remainder as 1 and the quotient as 23. So we'll write 23 here, remainder here. And it is 271 in the integral part. Now the fractional part, that is 0.232. So we multiply it by 8. So we get 1.856 over here. So from here we will only take up the integral part, which will be one of the digits in the fractional part. And now we take only the fractional part of this number and multiply it by 8. So let me do that. So we get 6.848. So we write 6 over here. Then we get 6.784 and we write the integral part over here. In case you are not getting all zeros in the decimal part and the multiplication continues, you can stop after 4 or 5 such products. So I am going to just go up to 5 places after the decimal point and then I will stop. We get 5. So I am not going to move any further now. I will stop at 5 places after the decimal. So this number becomes 0.16662. Now combining both the parts, the previous part was 271. Dot. So this is my answer. So this is how we convert decimal to octal. Now next we will be seeing octal to decimal conversion, just the opposite. Now as during the introduction to number systems, we already know that all these number systems are based on place value. That is every number, that is if I write here, if I write an octal number over here, like 271.324. So every digit over here will be having some weight. Like here it is 0, 1 and 2, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. This we all know. And these weights shall be raised to the power of 8. Because it is an octal number, so they shall be raised to the power of 8 in order to convert it to decimal. So as we already have written this number, let us try converting this octal number into the decimal form. So we have raised this weight to the power of 8 and multiplied with the digit, that is 2. Because here similarly in like if you take decimal numbers, if I have a decimal number like 298.32, so here also we have weights for each of the digits and we will raise them to the power of 10. So because it is quite clear over here that 2 is what it is at the hundreds place, 9 is at the tens place, 8 is at the units place. So 2 is multiplied by 100 as you can see from here, and 10 raised to the power 1 into 9, that is 90, and 10 raised to the power 0 into 8, that is 8. So ones units place, tens place and hundreds place. So same way here also we will be raising 8 to the power of these weights. Can write it this way. Now it will require a bit of calculation. So we get the answer 185.4140625, which is the decimal equivalent of this number, that is 271.324. So you can see as the base goes on increasing, so does the calculation also increases. Let's take up some questions. Convert the following octal numbers to decimal form. So we have 257 over here. So this is given in octal form and we have to convert it to decimal form. So we are going to write the number and assign weights, and now we are going to raise 8 to the power of these weights and multiply them with the digits according to the place value. As you can see, place value in the octal number. So we get the answer as 175. I'll just check it once again. Yes, so answer is 175. The second question, 3527. So here also we are going to write the numbers like this. Raise 8 to the power of these weights, multiply them with the digits. And now we'll solve them. So the answer is 1879. So this is my decimal number. As you can see, you can understand it by the digits which are greater than 7. So it is understandable that this number is definitely not an octal number. Third one, 123.14. So we will write the number, and we have a decimal point this time. So we are going to assign weights in the increasing order from 0 towards the left side, that is from right to left. And this side it will be minus 1 and minus 2. And again we are going to raise 8 to the power of these weights. And we will solve them. So the answer is this, that is 83.1875 to the base 10. Next, 605.12. We will be converting it to decimal. Again, write the digits and assign weights to the digits. Now raise 8 to the power of these weights. I've directly written 0 because anything multiplied by 0 will already give us 0. So the answer is 389.03125. So this is the decimal equivalent of 605.12, which is an octal number. So students, that's all in today's class. The last one, that is hexadecimal conversion, I hope you can do it on your own now, because all we have to do is to convert a decimal number to hexadecimal, we have to divide the number by 16 repeatedly and collect the remainders. And also over there on the other side, to convert hexadecimal to decimal, we just have to assign weights to the digits and raise 16 to the power of those weights and multiply them with individual digits. So I'll be taking that session in the next class. In the meantime, you can also practice it on your own. So please practice more examples of these types and try to solve them on your own and discuss the answers also in your group. In the next class, we would be discussing hexadecimal conversion. Thank you.